The time is now. The number one seeds will fight to the finish.
For the slam!
Are you unstoppable?
Stop him.
Who will cross the line? Carolina. Kansas. On your mark. Get set. Start your engine. Go. This is the Final Four.
Go, Sneak, go!
And our thanks to the cast of Speed Racer, which opens in theaters on May the 9th. And welcome back, everyone, to our New York studios as we approach tip-off for our second national semifinal game, Kansas against North Carolina. Our Sam Ryan caught up with North Carolina head coach Roy Williams just a short while ago.
Roy, a 15-game winning streak coming in, the overall number one seed. What is the confidence level like for your players?
Well, I hope it's very good, but all that stuff doesn't make any difference now. You got to play tonight, play the best basketball that we've played the entire season. But I do think our team is a confident team, as all four teams should be.
You know, Kansas is going to try to do its best to limit your transition game. What do you have to do to be successful against them?
Not allow them to let us, you know, to stop us. And that's the biggest thing is we think that's an advantage for us. We want to play that way, and we're going to try to play that way. But like the Washington State game, we can win in the 60s. It's just a lot more fun for us in the 80s and 90s.
This is your sixth trip to the Final Four. I know you tell your players to try to enjoy the ride. Are you enjoying the ride?
Not as much as I want our players to, but there's just so much work to be done. But you have a chance to sit back after it's over with and realize what a great year it is. But if you're this close, you want more.
Thank you, Roy.
Thank you very much.
You know, you sit there and you watch Roy Williams and you think about Ben Howland. You hope your team goes out and plays as well as it can, but you never really know for sure.
Yeah, you really don't know. And one of the keys for North Carolina is to do what it does best, which is run the ball up the floor, be solid defensively, make sure they don't forget about Hansborough and playing fast-paced basketball, and keep the game at a crisp pace.
Yeah, I think that last game tempo was a factor. UCLA would have liked to have made it a slower game. Roy Williams talking about it's a lot more fun for them to play in the 80s. I think Kansas feels the same way. I think both teams are going to try to get out in transition, try to run even after made baskets, and I think we're going to see a game getting into the 70s, probably even the 80s.
Does this feel like an even Steven game to you, Billy?
Well, a lot of talent on both sides, a lot of great matchups. I still think in the front court for Kansas, how they match up with Tyler Hansborough and control his energy, his competitiveness, and his game-changing plays is going to be critical. We also saw some foul trouble in last game. Memphis in the front court. Dorsey picked up his third foul early in the second half. It'll be interesting to see which front court gets in any potential foul trouble.
You saw Tyler Hansborough there just a second ago. You know he will figure prominently in what happens in game two this evening. Up next, we'll have an exclusive look inside the Kansas locker room as head coach Bill Self gets his Jayhawks ready. Don't go away. We're coming up on game two in San Antonio. Kansas will play North Carolina to see who qualifies for Monday night's championship game against the Memphis Tigers. Always interesting to hear a head coach's last words and final thoughts to his team just before they take the court for a big game. Give a listen to Bill Self in the Kansas locker room.
We are, and how happy we are for you, and how much we appreciate your efforts all year long to get to San Antonio. But getting here was tough, wasn't it? And the pressure we felt getting here wasn't deserved, but it's because the pressure of Kansas have been in three Elite Eights the last 5 years, and we ain't gotten here yet. And we felt that last week in a little bit, but still yet we prevailed. All right, this week you guys have handled it great. There's absolutely no pressure. This is the week we relax and go have fun. My challenge to you tonight is you have as much fun playing as I have coaching. And if you do that, we're gonna have a great time. I guarantee you that. We're playing a very good team, a team with great history, great tradition. You know what? They're playing a very, very good team and a program with unbelievable history and tradition. You came to Kansas to play in this game. You can't hope good things happen tonight. You expect them to happen, and they will, okay? Go out and relax best you can, and know it's a long game. And know there's going to be some anxious moments. And enjoy every second of it, guys. You deserve it. But always remember, as Coach Lombardi said, the most competitive men love the most competitive games. And this is one of those times. This is one of those games. And we all know how competitive you are. All right? I expect this to be a big celebration in here in about 2.5 hours. Everybody got that? Let's go make it happen.
So the Kansas Jayhawks getting all fired up as you take a live look at the Jayhawks out on the floor and now going back for one final moment in the locker room. I wish you could have been here in the studio with us and heard Billy Donovan talking about how laid back Bill Self was. I gather you were a little more excited and animated when you were going through that.
Well, I think Bill's also probably very excited too, but you try to keep your team calm and you want them focused on playing. I think every coach goes about it doing it a little bit differently. Bill knows his team very well, and they, you know what, they earned the right to get here. They should enjoy it, but you know Bill's intense, his staff is, and so his kids are, but you want them to go out there and play their best game today.
So you went about it how?
Well, I was maybe a little bit more intense, a little bit more aggressive, but that was just me. But, you know, you got to know your team, and I knew my team at Florida. They thrived off that. Joakim Noah, Al Horford, Corey Brewer, Torian Green, they liked that. So Bill's got a real good pulse in his team, and you know what? If he didn't, they wouldn't be at this point.
All right, we talked about game one. Let's talk about this game. What do you expect out of North Carolina and Kansas?
Well, I think you got maybe the most explosive offensive team in the country in North Carolina. I think transition defense for Kansas getting back is going to be critical, and I don't know if they can do it or anybody can do it, but it's a great challenge, and if they do it, they can stop a big part of North Carolina's offense. I think the other thing is Kansas is one of the better defensive teams in the country, so I think a lot of this could come down to foul trouble and matchups and how this game continues to progress and who really in the front court can handle which team's front court the best.
Seth Davis.
Got to make shots. I mean, just ask Ben Hallen the importance of doing that. The two guys who can really knock down outside shots for Kansas are Mario Chalmers and Brandon Rush. And I like Bill Self's cool approach. I think they are going to come out and play well. And if they can make those outside shots, I think their defense will take over. Remember, Louisville shot 53% against North Carolina, even in a losing effort. So the shots will be there. And then I think, you know, keep Tyler Hansbrough under control. Kansas marches on to Monday night.
Kansas can win if, in fact, they knock down perimeter shots. In losses this year, they've shot 27% from behind the three-point line. The front line has to compete with North Carolina's front line. They don't have to dominate, but they can't get pushed around in there. But I think at the end of the day, North Carolina prevails because it has too much offensive firepower, and this team will play a better defensive game than it played against Louisville.
All right, guys, North Carolina, Kansas. We'll see. Coming up, Kansas against North Carolina. The winner advances to Monday night's national title game against Memphis. Jim Nansen, Billy Packer will have the call after this message and a word from your local station.
Smart takes the shot.
Welcome back to national semifinal game number two here in San Antonio, Kansas and North Carolina about to leave the locker rooms and take the floor here at the Alamo Dome for the right to advance to Monday night's national championship game, where already the Memphis Tigers have advanced by virtue of their win over UCLA. And again, welcome back, friends. Jim Nance along with Billy Packer, and this is a much ballyhooed matchup. All the history, the intertwined history between these two programs, Kansas and North Carolina. Billy, let's talk about some things to look for in this one, beginning with the Jayhawks of Kansas.
Well, without question, you have some role players that come off the bench. Josh Akana, Jerron Collins, an inside and outside combination that have played extremely well all year long, particularly now that Collins is back in good health. And the guard play for the Jayhawks and Russell Robertson, Mario Chalmers, two of the best at both the offensive and the defensive end of the floor. And you've got Brandon Rush, another one of these great slashing players that helps Kansas score on their half-court offense.
Then, of course, the North Carolina Tar Heels East Regional champs. You must start, of course, Tyler Hansbrough.
Yeah, if you're going to look for somebody, Tyler Hansbrough, the National Player of the Year, a tremendous all-around player. He gives incredible effort, but he has outstanding skill as well. He runs the floor as well as any big guy going. Ty Lawson, he was out for 6 games this year in North Carolina, learned how to play without them. They don't have to worry about that anymore. Really knows how to push the ball at the floor. And Danny Green, another one of those guys that can come off the bench and not take up minutes, but actually star.
Kansas and North Carolina, so much history, so much to be decided shortly here in San Antonio. J. Jayhawks and Tar Heels coming up. Let's go over to Sam Ryan. Sam?
And Jim, a tough emotional loss for Kansas heading into this one. Senior guard Roderick Stewart, his season is over. His college career is over. He suffered a fractured left kneecap during practice yesterday. Now, he was going up for a dunk and slipped on a wet spot, ending his college career. He said he's going to wait until he returns to Lawrence to have surgery. Wanted to be here with the team tonight. He will be on the bench in sweats tonight, Jim.
Thank you, Sam. Such a sad story. And he was a part of that really first nine-man rotation. Stewart out tonight.
CBS Sports exclusive coverage of the men's national semifinals is sponsored by Coke Zero, Nike Spark Training, Lowe's, and by Pontiac.
The tournament has its final four. We have our final eight at Pontiac.com/NCAA. Eight schools are competing for the Pontiac game-changing performance of the tournament. Here are four of the plays. Kevin Love of UCLA with this dunk helped bring the Bruins back to the Final Four. Tyler Hansbrough's jumper provided North Carolina with its ticket to San Antonio. Derrick Rose led the way, putting Memphis in its first Final Four since 1985. Sharon Collins' basket gave Kansas the late lead over Davidson on the way to the Jayhawks' win. Go to Pontiac.com/NCAA to see all eight nominees. Your vote will help determine which school wins the $100,000 scholarship contribution from Pontiac. While there, enter to win one of eight $8,000 scholarships to help you or someone in your family pay for school.
Welcome back to San Antonio here on CBS. Ladies and gentlemen, let's meet the participants in our second national semifinal. Big 12 conference champion Kansas, making its third Final Four appearance in the last 7 years and 13th overall. Let's meet Coach Bill Self's Kansas Jayhawks.
Rock, chalk,
rock, chalk.
Rock, chalk, Jayhawk.
Don't worry, it's a Kansas thing.
How did we get here?
Portland State.
UNLV.
Villanova.
Davidson.
Wasn't easy, but now we're here. The Final Four.
We are.
We are.
We are.
Kansas.
Starting tonight for the University of Kansas Jayhawks at forward, a 6'9 sophomore from Dallas, Texas, number 00, Darrell Arthur. At forward, a 6'8 senior from Oklahoma City, Oklahoma, number 32, Darnell Jackson. At guard, a 6'1 senior from New York, New York, number 3, Russell Robinson. At guard, a 6'1 junior from Anchorage, Alaska, number 15, Mario Chalmers. At guard, a 6'6 junior from Kansas City, Missouri, number 25, Brandon Rush. Head coach for the Kansas Jayhawks is Bill Self. ACC champion North Carolina back in the Final Four after winning the championship in 2005. Here are Coach Roy Williams, North Carolina Tar Heels.
Maybe you've heard of us.
Michael Jordan.
James Worthy. Dean Smith.
Following a long line of tradition.
Now it's our time.
How did we get here?
Mount St. Mary.
Arkansas.
Washington State.
Louisville. It's been a long road, but it's paid off.
And now
we're here.
Final Four. We are.
We are.
We are.
North Carolina.
Starting tonight for the University of North Carolina Tar Heels, at forward, a 6'5 junior from Alexandria, Virginia, number 1, Marcus Guignard. At forward, a 6'8 sophomore from Torrance, California, number 21, Deion Thompson. At forward, a 6'9 junior from Poplar Bluff, Missouri, number 50, Tyler Hansbrough. At guard, a 5'11 sophomore from Clinton, Maryland, number 5, Ty Lawson. At guard, a 6'4 sophomore from Wynnewood, Pennsylvania, number 22, Wayne Ellington. Head coach for the North Carolina Tar Heels is Roy Williams. Kansas and North Carolina, Billy Packer, and what's your overview on this one?
Well, Jim, both of these teams like to push the ball up and down the floor. I think the real key statistic is the fact that they both shoot around 50%, but Kansas holds opponents to 37%. That is something to look at early in this ballgame.
The Midwest Regional Champion Jayhawks, their road to San Antonio. Portland State, UNLV, Villanova, and then Davidson. One of the biggest stories of this entire tournament, that magical run by the Wildcats that came up just short at the end, with Kansas prevailing 59-57 to grab the fourth and final spot here at the Final Four late Sunday. Then you got North Carolina by way of Raleigh and then Charlotte. Now St. Mary's over 100 in their first two games, blowing out Arkansas, Washington State, and Louisville. They've only trailed for 4 minutes and 45 seconds during the entire tournament. Our game is brought to you in HDTV by HP. Tony Green, Tom Eads, Vern Harris draw the assignment tonight. Kansas and North Carolina, and here we go. Chalmers grabs it for the Jayhawks.
Good steal to the tap by Arthur, beating Hansbrough to the ball.
And it's Arthur over Hansbrough for the opening two.
Really critical for Arthur to get going offensively to force Hansbrough to work. Hansbrough is not a shot blocker, so you can go ahead and put your low post shots up.
This game, Billy, expected at breakneck speed, right?
I would imagine that. I'd be surprised this game's played under 80.
Ellington, stop for a minute. Here's Deion Thompson.
Good quick defense, good stepping out.
Lawson hands it over to Hansbrough. Spins on Arthur, puts up the shot and matches Arthur's basket at the other end.
Yeah, that is really not even a shot. It's a throw, and yet it's so soft. It's amazing how he does that.
It's like with his strength, his body is like he's able to create some sort of separation to get a shot that looks like it could be easily blocked, but he's pushed the defender away. This time over the top. They go right over Hansbrough for the basket.
Really like what Bill Self is doing. He's saying Hansbrough's a guy that puts up a lot of points offensively. Let's make him work on the defensive end of the floor. He's getting no help in the low post.
And it's Jackson who just converted at the other end, coming up with the ball at this end.
A change defensive assignment. Hansbrough goes out on Jackson. Puts Thompson down inside on Arthur.
Robinson's got a wide open three and knocks it down.
Really a key for Kansas to shoot well from the perimeter. When they do, they are so tough.
North Carolina already with its largest deficit of the tournament. They've run right through everyone by the widest margin on any run in its storied history to the Final Four. Lawson on the baseline, trying to wiggle free, and that is shut off.
Rush getting out on the break nicely.
Ginyard trying to draw the charge, no call. Rush jumper over everything. Ellington coming out with it for the Tar Heels.
He'd have been better to rotate that ball back outside.
Pull up shot, Ellington knocks it in for a two, not a three.
But Jim, here we're going to see Ellington has size on Chalmers, and we've seen this in the tournament. Bigger guards shooting over smaller guards, even those that play pretty good defense. Saw that in the first game with Collison.
Over the top again. Arthur snags it, knocks it down.
Big to big. Really nice strategy by Bill Self. He's making the North Carolina big men have to guard somebody, and they're getting no help.
And good, quick passing. Hansbrough driving on Jackson. He backs it home.
Did I say the game would be in the 80s, Jim? I may change that to the 90s.
Underestimated this, my friend. Might be there by halftime the way they're going.
Like the way Kansas has this floor spread, really utilizing their big men with a lot of space inside.
Arthur fade away, rolls off the rim, saved by Ellington to Hansbrough.
North Carolina does not look as quick to me as they did, Jim, when we saw them in Raleigh. They exploded there, and here their legs look a little heavy to me early.
Thompson and nice a steal. Out. Robinson nearly able to make the theft. Thompson didn't see him coming in on him. Now it's Lawson. Tipped over the Rush. He's got Chalmers ahead.
Why he didn't pass it earlier?
Chalmers could have given it back to Rush,
yep.
too. Going to be on Guignard.
Now what's going to happen right there if you're going to see Lawson penetrating to the inside because Chalmers, Rush, and Robinson are outside. No defensive balance for North Carolina. Kind of an easy break.
Well, you saw the Tar Heels the first two rounds of the tournament up in Raleigh coming off their ACC tournament win. And you just marveled at their quickness, their legs. But you look at Kansas right now, this looks like what we saw out of North Carolina and Raleigh, the way Kansas is jumping around this floor.
Absolutely. They seem to be much quicker on the floor. North Carolina goes to their bench early, and Kansas will do that likewise, coming in with an explosive Collins, so they'll get even quicker.
Sasha Kahn comes in. Kansas, and it's Stevenson and Green for the Tar Heels.
And Jim, let's put something in perspective. The last game Kansas played was Davidson, right down to the wire. The first game North Carolina played this year was Davidson, right down to the wire. They beat them 72-68. So this Davidson club from the beginning to the end was a factor.
Chalmers unable to hit the free throws.
Now it's going to be Collins on Lawson, even though the Kansas switches.
Davidson played every team here at the Final Four at some point during the season, except Memphis. They had UCLA on the ropes early, too. Hansbrough, that one's rocking. Arthur says not a chance. Rush up ahead, plays it in.
Second time in this ball game that a good double down from the weak side has paid off for Kansas.
Green is knocked to the floor, no call, and it's last touch by Green.
No question about it, early on in this ball game, Kansas much quicker. Hansbrough doesn't see the weak side help coming. Kansas off to the races with excellent fast-breaking basketball.
Quinton Thomas, the holdover from its championship team, now defending here on Collins. Again, they go up over the top. Great catch by Kahn, unable to make the short shot.
North Carolina has numbers.
That ball, last touch by Kansas. It'll belong to Carolina out of the break. The full fury of Kansas unleashed here at the start. 11-6 lead at the first break. Memphis with a 78-63 victory over UCLA. Derrick Rose had 25, but Chris Douglas Roberts with 28. And Joey Dorsey didn't score, but had 15 rebounds as they knock out the Bruins. Carolina to inbound, down 11-6 here early. And that's a reach-in call on Sasha Kahn.
Not the kind of foul you want to commit when things are going your way and you're Kansas. Jim, isn't it interesting? Kansas is a team. Not one Kansas player was selected by the media for all-conference Big 12. Four guys got votes, but nobody made first team the media. Now, two guys did it to the coaches, but shows you the balance on this team probably hurt itself for postseason accolades.
Boy, they do share the glory, though,
yes,
don't they?
Yes, they do.
You don't get a guy with a breakout scoring game. Stevenson had a good chance to score inside, but took his eye off of it.
Does not have the best of hands. Green has to recognize that.
Here's Collins, their super sub.
A tough assignment for Thomas. They're going right over the top with their big men. Better adjustment by North Carolina that time. Stevenson helping out.
Still, Arthur had a good chance to make the play on that one. They dropped it in over Hansbrough, but goes out of bounds.
Lawson out, getting the break early.
Danny Green's
got the jump shot opportunity. Doesn't take it.
Everybody left him. That'll take it. Here's the three for Green.
Very important that he gets off early. Chalmers with a good rebound and a push here. North Carolina will not be able to take any breaks. because Kansas likes to push the ball up the court as well as they do.
Now Rush back out high. Chalmers, we can beat you so many ways. To Arthur with Stevenson trying to defend. Arthur all net.
Second beautiful turnaround jump shot by Arthur. Nice follow through.
Now Hansbrough driving and drawing that one on Khan. So Khan with two quick ones. Inside, though, they've been getting some action, the Jayhawks.
They really have. They've gone down and low, and I think it's an excellent maneuver to make Hansbrough play defensive so that he has to work on both ends of the floor. They've been throwing the ball right over the top nicely. Jim, one of the things about Kansas, too, they can rotate their big men pretty well. Khan got two, that one cheap foul on the reach hurt him. But they can come in with Cole Aldridge as well. So they've got four men to rotate. He'll be coming in right now. So the foul trouble really not part of Bill Self's problem.
So Cole Aldridge, the freshman out of Minnesota. Jackson returns. Robinson returns.
Right, the one guy you don't want in foul trouble is Arthur. He's fouled out four times this year. And you want him on the floor because of his offensive prowess. Hansbrough, more attempts and more makes than any player in Atlantic Coast Conference history from the foul line in 3 years.
He's going to get a breather here with Deion Thompson coming back. He broke Christian Leitner's free throw marks, attempts, and makes.
Who played 4 years of college basketball. Big screen by Jackson out front.
Aldridge. Collins so quick, gets by everyone.
Collins is quick. He's got that big upper body. Loves to penetrate. The young man had obviously problems this year physically. It took him a long time to get back, but he's another one of those guys who can come off the bench and be a star in a ball game. As is Green, who's back in for North Carolina.
Kansas has five baskets, made baskets in the paint, leading at 15-8.
Roy Williams really going to this bench early. Lawson going to be coming back in. Not a lot of scoring on the floor right now for North Carolina. There's a walk.
Green saw Rush crashing in on him. Tune in to NCAA March Madness Central, powered by the first ever Pontiac G8. For complete coverage from the Final Four, check it out tomorrow night on the CBS College Sports Network.
Can we talk about these great programs? North Carolina 6-2 all time against Kansas. Three of those games in the Final Four. There's another lob, but not read very well by Rush.
It's Thompson.
Nice soft touch.
Yep. He's starting to come on during this NCAA tournament.
Yeah, he really had a tough ACC tournament, then came on strong. Another good drive. North Carolina not squaring up against these guards early on outside.
So Thompson makes the hoop, but at the other end commits the foul. That will send Russell Robinson to the line.
You know, it's funny, when you think back to history, there's so much connection between North Carolina and Kansas. Roy Williams, two of those three Final Four matchups had Roy Williams coaching at Kansas. The one where he defeated a Dean Smith team.
91.
Right, and then got beat by North Carolina's rivalry Duke. And then, of course, in 93, when Dean Smith won the championship with his outstanding team, they got beat in the semifinals by that club.
Three times in the past, the 57 epic battles, the triple overtime Carolina win, the other one. So they meet for the fourth time in the NCAA Final Four.
Hansbrough getting a pretty long rest here in the first half with his team down.
Hansbrough now back off the bench and checking in.
Lawson hadn't been able to turn the corner on Collins or Robinson so far.
Stevenson pinned. Spins around, pivots pass, but it's blocked.
Who gets the loose ball? Kansas.
Collins goes underneath. Aldridge on the follow.
Right now, North Carolina, compared to what we've seen in the NCAA tournament, Jim, and Lawson takes a shot in the eye. They are really out of sync in regard to the team they have on the floor. Good drive to the inside. Nobody blocked it out. Aldridge comes down and puts it away.
Jackson commits the foul at the other end. Watch the freshman and Jackson both going in. So Aldrich, you got the hand on it.
Saw Stevens late getting there. Hansborough back into the ball game, has not been able to get off track. Nice lob. That's blocked. It's kicked out by Arthur. Sent away. Jim, I talked about the quick legs. It seems like Kansas is getting every single loose ball.
Bouncing it in to Aldrich. One pass too many. Trying to work it back over to Arthur, and Carolina takes it away. Kansas has not trailed in this game. They've got their biggest lead here at 9.
See Ellington coming back in the ball game. Roy Williams looks like he's wanting to get that starting lineup back on the floor.
Robinson commits his first. So after all the rotation, Carolina back out there with its first five.
Getting no free looks from the outside at all. North Carolina, another good quick.
Chalmers wasn't looking, but they still have it. There's another quick move by Collins.
Isn't it amazing, Jim, what quick legs will do, huh? Kansas get all the loose balls.
Another one. That's Chalmers. Banks it in.
Roy Williams doesn't want to call a timeout. He wants his team to push it up the floor, but they're pushing up the floor against somebody that's quicker.
Next whistle will bring the automatic free timeout. All five Kansas starters have scored. They're on an 8-0 run, and they're looking for another theft. Ellington bounced it over to Lawson. That was some heads-up play.
Terrific defense so far by Kansas.
And again, that one's kicked. It'll be Carolina ball out of the break. So they were able to save a timeout, North Carolina, with the under 12 timeout. Kansas shooting 71%. A blitz of a start. What hustle by Kansas already with 4 steals, 3 blocks, forcing 6 turnovers.
Jim, we see this defensive intensity. North Carolina weak side help. All loose balls going to Kansas. There's weak side help again starting to break. Hansborough doesn't realize the weak side help is coming. Again, rush off on the break. Just been tremendous defense by Kansas. They're number one in their conference, number 3 nationally in regard to percentage defense. And they are showing why tonight. Here comes another double team on Hansborough.
Hansborough puts up the shot. Ginyard comes flying in.
Loose ball.
It's Robinson in Kansas. Other side of the court, rush. They're just flying up and down the floor. A 10-0 run by the Jayhawks.
North Carolina can't get any semblance of half-court offense going.
Ellington speeds past rush. And that's a charge. Everything going Kansas's way.
As fine a weak side defense as you'll see played in college basketball is what we're seeing from Bill Self's team. Roy Williams can't believe it. This is not a North Carolina team he has seen play in months.
A North Carolina team that's won its last 15 games, went 36-2 on the year.
Well, they started 18-0 on the year. Kansas started 20-0.
Up 15, looking for more.
Nice screen.
Rush with a 3. Can you believe it? What a performance.
Beautiful screen that time by Jackson to set up Rush's shot. Another loose ball.
Again, Kansas has it. They tie it up by the time they get there, and it stays the arrow with North Carolina.
Roy Williams looking at the club he used to coach, playing a magnificent first half. Getting every single loose ball. North Carolina has not had an opportunity to get anything going in their half-court set. This is some performance.
4 baskets, 7 turnovers.
Sometimes when you've been winning big, Jim, you lose sight of how to play the game when you get to some adversity. North Carolina right now, and there was another example, taking a bad shot, not getting anything working.
Well, they had a chance. They say it was touched last by North Carolina.
Again, you've got a piece of it.
And he's not arguing the call. North Carolina played on this floor at the Alamo Dome in the 98 Final Four and fell to Utah in the national semifinal right in this spot.
of Bill Self worked so hard to get to a Final Four, and it was a trouble, but this has been no trouble for him. This is one of the most devastating performances I've seen by two teams that were fairly evenly matched.
Billy, can you believe Carolina's down 21? They've given up 16 unanswered.
Almost lost another one.
There's a reach-in call on Kansas.
North Carolina right now, Jim, feels like they're playing against seven defensive men. That's how quick Kansas has been in this first half.
That was on Chalmers. Today's your last chance to vote for the Pontiac game-changing performance of the tournament at Pontiac.com/NCAA. A $100,000 scholarship is on the line.
And Jim, if you're North Carolina right now, you don't want to start kicking back into this lead and think you got to bring it back all at one time. They've got to figure out how to get in their normal half-court sets.
There's a foul in midair.
And if you're Kansas, you don't want to be that much that aggressive. North Carolina's causing their own problems.
That is on Jackson, his second. And they instantly bring in Aldridge. Jackson to the bench with the two. Cole Aldridge, a 6'11 freshman from Bloomington, Minnesota. Last year's Mr. Basketball in that state. Ellington opened three.
Had to alter the shot on that jump shot. Again, trying to come back too quickly.
Collins almost dragged the foot.
Good post up.
Arthur over Green, big advantage. Aldridge fighting for it. Out battles Hansbrough and draws the foul. Wow.
Jim, is there any phase of this game in which Kansas, forget about being better, isn't dominant? There's Aldridge going over Hansbrough. How often have you seen Hansbrough been out battled for a rebound inside? Danny Green comes over, not much he could do other than commit the foul.
So Aldridge already with a tip-in basket to shoot two, give the freshman now 3 points on the night.
Young man, McDonald's All-American, big things expected of him. He's really lost a lot of weight. You can see Roy Williams trying to do anything he can, settle Ellington down. But I think he may have to stay with that starting lineup so that they can get into some kind of flow.
Brings in Will Graves for the first time.
Graves is a shooter. Somebody in the lane too soon.
He's going to get one more chance. North Carolina in early.
This is a nightmare for Roy Williams, who has now elevated himself in winning percentage. Number three all time. Behind the likes of some of the greatest coaches that have ever been in the game, but tonight he is looking at a nightmare.
That lane violation cost him a point. Quentin Thomas back out. Green to the bench. Can you believe this now? 18-0 run. Eight consecutive empty trips down the floor for North Carolina. Will it end here?
You have the freshman on Hansbrough. See if they can get him the ball in the low post by calming down a little bit.
Graves trying to come in and deliver. Off the rim. Again, Aldridge giving them a spark off the bench. Everybody for Kansas playing well.
But if you're North Carolina, you don't want to bring Graves into the game, and then all of a sudden he's going to try to play one-on-one, and there's Hansbrough picking up the cheap foul.
Aldridge.
Yep.
And Hansbrough able to force it and act it out.
And that's just a freshman learning what he can and cannot do. Hansbrough, seasoned veteran, picking up a cheap one. North Carolina really with not much of its shooting power out on the wings right now.
North Carolina scoreless for the last 4 minutes and 35 seconds.
How about the overplays by Kansas?
Every shot, every pass contested.
Yep.
Lawson. Hansbrough.
Nothing easy.
Blocked, but a hack. And it's on Chalmers, his second.
And how about the way they're distributing some of these fouls around, Jim, and the fact that they've got four big men to play with 20 fouls out there, but here the guards even helping out inside.
Hansbrough already been at the line tonight and hit a couple, now adds a third. That breaks the 18-0 run with that free throw.
That Eastern Regional Most Valuable Player. The Atlantic Coast Conference Player of the Year. You'd have to probably say consensus National Player of the Year, but he's looking at a swarming defense on him here tonight.
Got so many different National Player of the Year awards out there. He's already collected seven pieces of hardware, and I know there's more on the way. Hansbrough with 8 of the 12 points for the Tar Heels.
Pretty nice defense by Lawson. Doesn't let Collins turn the corner.
Robinson with the 3. Tipped up by Aldridge.
Oh, he is so active in there.
Wow. Basket. Taken away.
Well, worth the gamble, though, if you're Collins. He's got a lot of strength. He goes inside. No question, body contact there. They're waiting on him. Here's Graves, a man that likes to shoot from outside, but he's come in the game. Tried 3 individual plays, so you're trying to come back with guys off the bench. Probably not good strategy for North Carolina.
They've missed their last 8 shots. Under 8 to go in the first half. Total domination so far. Arthur, too strong, but a follow-up by Rush.
Jim, the national championship on the college level is not the best of 3 series. It's 1 and done, and North Carolina right now is facing that early in this ball game.
Rush, way outside 3. Of course. Of course.
This game is over.
Is it?
Yes, it is.
Wow. With 7.5 to go in the first half, Kansas pummeling North Carolina. Absolutely shell-shocked, everybody in the North Carolina family.
Absolutely. As I said, Roy Williams now number 3 in all-time winning percentage behind Claire B and Adolph Rupp. He's passed John Wooden. He's won a game in 19 straight NCAA tournaments like no coach has ever done before, but he's got a team right now totally out of sync.
Arthur got poked in the eye.
And all of his players, Jim, are trying to bring it back with one shot.
He's brought in Mike Copeland for the first time tonight. We have another timeout with the injury. Kansas never trailing, and the lead is biggest of the night at 26. Getting a scholarship with 0 skills, about as unbelievable as getting real Coke taste and 0 calories. Win a $25,000 scholarship from Coke Zero at mycokerewards.com. Jim Nance and Billy Packer here in San Antonio, and Kansas pouring it on here. The biggest deficit, Billy, ever in a Final Four game. We did it.
We remember that game, yep. And all of a sudden that Shane Battier and his ball club stuck together and played solid and brought that ball game back. What I see in North Carolina, guys trying to do it one-on-one with jump shots, that's not the answer.
Arthur got poked in the eyes, still on the floor, out of the break. Aldridge turnaround jumper, and it falls.
And again, great strategy by Bill Self, making Hansbrough play defense. He is not a shot blocker, and so consequently, the big men are just going right at him and taking their normal shot.
This high-scoring Carolina team without a basket. 7 minutes, and Aldridge says, get that out of here. Dana Green's going to come back out for North Carolina. In for Copeland.
Jim, how about this weak side defensive help by Kansas all night? And what makes that is that the North Carolina players are trying to do everything with one-on-one activity.
Made only 4 out of 19 from the field. That was touched by Kansas. 17 on the shot clock.
Well, I said something had to give. Kansas holding teams to 37% field goal shooting percentage. And they're certainly doing that to North Carolina now.
Pass almost got away. Ellington trying to create. Slips. Aldridge with it.
Weak side help. Much quicker.
Loose ball to the Jayhawks again. Rush. What a pass. Charge though. Hansbrough for the second time in this half draws the charge.
And Jim, there's something that players have not recognized. Hansbrough is not a shot blocker. So when you drive down, look to take your shot. Don't look to go ahead and penetrate any further. He is going to play for position and not try to block the shots.
Guignard, he'll try one on top of the key. No.
Again, one-on-one basketball.
8 minutes without a field goal for North Carolina.
A team that looked like they could not be stopped offensively in this tournament previously.
Arthur got it over to Aldridge. and the short shot, he was a little off balance.
Would you say the freshman McDonald's All-Americans having a pretty good first half?
You know, when we saw him a few weeks ago in College Station against Texas A&M, just in practice, you could see the future of Kansas basketball.
Oh, absolutely. Legitimate 6'11", long arms, and he's got himself in great shape. And
look at that. Danny Green had it, and Arthur just came right over. Beat him to the spot. Kansas this time, though, turns it over.
One of the first times today that Kansas not able to execute on the break. But it was so obvious in the first couple of minutes of this game how much quicker Kansas was. They're getting every loose ball. Their game plan was great to go right at Hansborough on the defensive end of the floor.
North Carolina stuck at 12. 13.
There's
make
help
it 14
again.
Consecutive empty trips. Collins. Robinson almost got up to keep it for Kansas. Lawson, he'll drive in. Is this a charge? No, it's going to go against Kansas.
And Jim, you might run out of energy. Here we see Brandon Rush, who has made the open shots. There was the great solid screen to get the ball cross court. Goes up on the boards. Much as we saw in the first game by the Memphis team, he's one of those guys. It's a tough matchup. Long, 6'5", 6'6".
He's got as many points as the North Carolina team, hitting 5 out of 6 from the field. Now Lawson to shoot 2.
And you can see North Carolina out of sync. Lawson came into this game, Jim, in 8 NCAA tournament career games, 45 assists and only 15 turnovers. That's a 3-to-1 ratio, as pretty simple to figure out. But tonight, his team has been so out of sync, he hasn't even been able to run the half-court offense.
Kansas brings in number 10, senior Jeremy Case, the last Roy Williams recruit.
Aldridge might as well clean up the floor. He's done everything else out here properly.
Yeah. You saw Case. He came to Kansas in the fall after their Final Four run of 2003, where they lost to Syracuse and Carmelo Anthony in the championship. Case came to Kansas just a few months later, recruited by Roy Williams.
Quentin Thomas into the ball game, and the only holdover, as you mentioned, for that 05 national championship team. This game is not quite going like that 05 run did. Good back screen that time by Aldridge.
Collins wanting to challenge Thomas. Now Hansborough tried to pass it back to Aldridge. Taken by Ellington. Floater goes and one.
And Jim, if North Carolina has a chance, and this is going to take an awful lot of energy, it will be doing just that. Push the ball up the court and just try to turn this into a 110-point game. But that takes a lot of energy as far down as they are.
Billy, that's the first basket made by the Heels in 9 minutes and 3 seconds.
Well, I credit it somewhat to the fact that they didn't get in their offense at all, but I'll give more credit to Kansas and terrific half-court defense with tremendous weak side help.
Ellington makes it a 3-point trip.
Kansas walks it up for the first time. They really have North Carolina spread out.
Carolina. That
nice move right here by Kansas. Spread North Carolina out, make them really work on defense and take away any energy they have.
Collins and the rebound, Hansborough. Almost had it tipped away.
Nice crossover by Ellington.
Blocked by Aldridge. Hansborough dumps it down.
And again, this is what North Carolina may have to do. Just push that ball up the court. Stay out of their half-court sets at all and just force the action.
The last 7 points to North Carolina. Rush, floater,
charge, and there it is again. He is not going to block the shots. He's going to draw charges.
Third time for Hansborough drawing the charge. It's 2 on Rush from 28 to 21. Well, this week marks the 20-year anniversary of Danny Manning and the Miracles winning the championship in 88, defeating Oklahoma in the final in Kansas City. What a night it was.
Jim, an Oklahoma team that had to add the better of that young man who grew up in Greensboro, North Carolina. Everybody assumed he would be a Tar Heel, and then He and his father and Larry Brown took off to Kansas, and the rest was history. Still their all-time leading scorer with 2,951 points and leading rebounder.
Now an assistant on Bill Self's squad.
That's the kind of shot Ellington has got to make. You know, one thing Kansas has gotten away from, and I think that it's something that they better go back to, and that is getting the ball down inside of their big men. There it is. Arthur pinched, short with the shot, Green.
Beautiful bounce. Pass,
but again to the wrong man.
Bounce pass.
Stevenson
almost
does not have good hands.
Almost went in. It actually ricocheted off the backboard. Thomas pull-up jumper. That's nothing but short.
Nobody else down. I can't believe Rose took that shot. It was 5-on-1 North Carolina's favorite. Kansas not taking advantage of this nice lead they've got.
Well, that's 10 unanswered now by North Carolina.
That was not a smart play by Robinson.
From 40 to 12 to 40 to 22. Coming up on AT&T at the half, we'll talk live with John Calipari and Chris Douglas Roberts, plus an AT&T Naismith Watch update. It's all coming up with Greg Clark, Seth, and Billy Donovan on the AT&T at the half. Carolina making a little run.
Making a big run. They've settled, slowed things down, and Kansas has gotten away from that ball going inside to their big people.
Jayhawks have missed their last five shots. Aldrich is open. Aldrich misses the dunk.
Had an easy put away. Kansas getting very confident right now.
Green, that would have been huge. Would have brought him within 15. Bounce pass perfect to Chalmers. Stolen by Robinson. Hansbrough fed it right to him.
And you know, that was Hansbrough to Lawson. Two experienced players should never let that happen.
That was some bounce pass.
But Jim, you're looking at Collins, Chalmers, and Robinson out there. Three guys, all that can play the point. So you're going to get some good passing on the break.
Seven on the shot clock. Chalmers with Ellington defending. Chalmers shot.
Had to go left hand. Kansas getting a little sloppy, Jim, with this lead.
Lawson got stuck. This loose ball goes to North Carolina. Thompson, short shot, no.
He hadn't missed many of those. Collins is the one that's got all the energy now.
Back out high, Arthur, two-point shot,
wide.
Hansbrough pulls it down. Under a minute to go in the half.
Kansas's decision making here is really not good. Bill Self has got to, in effect, calm his team down.
Danny Green with another three. At about a 12-second differential on the clock.
And you know what's interesting, Jim? The Kansas players are tired. That energy that they had at the beginning of the game has worn them down.
It had to happen.
Yeah.
The way they expended so much.
Look at Robinson out here. He's tired. Chalmers over on the other side, bending over, holding his knees. Aldrich doing likewise inside. That has to give some life to North Carolina.
Almost a turnover, and it is. It's Green. Laying it in again. North Carolina trying to work back into this thing.
Oh, they've got the 15.
Almost.
He was over the line.
Chalmers was in the air, but he got it away, I think, in time. And that's not going to go against Hansbrough this time.
Probably only because Collins' quickness. Hansbrough was right there.
Kenyard back on the floor. That's the first on Hansbrough.
Well, Jim, you remember that Maryland-Duke game, and I would say that as opposed to this one, I thought Maryland was still playing solid basketball, and Duke just played great basketball. Right now, Kansas has letting this game get away from them.
I also remember another major switch in momentum was out in Seattle in 89 with Seton Hall and Duke.
Yep.
Complete reversal. Right before the half, the shot's up, and it counts. Sherron Collins.
That was a huge basket for Kansas.
Gives him the 17-point bulge at the intermission.
Young man is so strong when he takes it inside despite his height.
Kansas had its biggest lead at 40-12. North Carolina with a 15-4 spurt to close the half. Greg Gumpel and company coming up here on CBS.
CBS Sports presents AT&T at the half. Your world delivered.
The score at halftime of our second national semifinal, Kansas leading North Carolina by 17, 44-27. Hi once again, everyone, and welcome to AT&T at the half. I'm Greg Gumbel, along with Clark Kellogg, Seth Davis, and Florida Gators head coach Billy Donovan. The second highest scoring team in the country comes up with a season low for a half with 27 points, and it's been quite a performance by the Kansas Jayhawks.
Unbelievable performance. Everybody's stunned with how well Kansas has played and how poorly North Carolina has played. Kansas shot 55% in the first half because they were able to get to the rim, either making shots off the initial thrust or putbacks. Here's Collins driving to the goal. North Carolina does not have a shot blocker, so anytime Kansas was able to get inside, they had smooth sailing to the rim. +9 on the backboards in that first half for Kansas, doing a nice job boxing out. But North Carolina, after getting down early, started taking quick perimeter shots that allowed Kansas to do a nice job on the defensive backboards.
All right, Billy Donovan, what did you see in the first half that impressed you?
Well, I think when you talk about their defense and their energy, Kansas got to begin with the low post. Kansas' defense built around not letting the ball get into the lane. Cole Aldridge, Darnell Jackson, great trap on Deion Thompson. Cole Aldridge recognized that Deion Thompson dribbles the ball back out. He goes back to his man, plays the post one-on-one. They got Deion Thompson in a tough situation off the block, not letting the ball into the post. And then great recognition here by Cole Aldridge coming along to block the shot. Now you got to really, really love the aggressiveness, the energy, and the way Kansas came up with loose basketballs. There's Darnell Jackson out there as a front court player. And then who blocked the shot? Cole Aldridge, who's running the floor, making a tremendous hustle play to tip it in. Cole Aldridge, first half, 6 points, 6 rebounds, and 3 blocks, a great boost off the bench.
Meanwhile, Seth, Carolina wasn't doing much right.
Yeah, you know, if Carolina looks slow out there, I think it may be because Kansas is so fast. They are absolutely swarming the basketball. North Carolina has 10 turnovers in the first half to just 2 assists, but on 7 of those turnovers, Kansas was able to make a steal. They're absolutely swarming the basketball, and then, of course, they're doing a great job at cashing in on the other end. Kansas clearly firing on all cylinders, and Tyler Hansbrough, he's been, well, just okay in the first half. Kansas doing a pretty good job keeping him in check. This is early on. Now, that's a shot that Bill Self can live with. If Tyler Hansbrough wants to maneuver on the perimeter and score that way, then he can have those points. Anytime he's been near the basket, he has been absolutely swarmed. And we did talk about before the game, Tyler Hansbrough might be the best single big man on the court, but Kansas has 4 guys they can rotate through the front court, including Cole Aldridge. Now, Kansas has to play with a big lead. Not always so easy.
What it adds up to is a 44-27 lead for Kansas at halftime. Let's look at 2 of the finalists for this year's Naismith Trophy presented by AT&T, one of whom playing in this game. Clark.
Tyler Hansbrough has already captured a couple of Player of the Year awards, and he certainly is deserving. Averaging over 20 points a game, 10 rebounds, Player of the Year in the ACC, leading his team here tonight with 10 points. The other candidate, Michael Beasley, the outstanding freshman, led the nation in rebounding, Big 12 Player of the Year, and also gave Kansas State its first tournament win since 1988. A terrific year for Michael Beasley.
And now you can be part of college basketball history. Text the word VOTE to 87654 to vote for the winner of the 2008 Naismith Trophy. The fans' vote counts for 25% of the total. In the first of our national semifinal games earlier on CBS, Memphis over UCLA. Let's talk about it, Clark.
Well, you take a look at Memphis CDR. Chris Douglas Roberts going to work 2 of his 28 right there. And then Russell Westbrook going to find his way inside against that Memphis defense. Westbrook again on a nice pass from Kevin Love.
Yeah, he had 22 points, one of the few bright spots for UCLA. Memphis just got out on the break. That's Antonio Anderson with the finish. And speaking of finishes, Kevin Love, congratulations. You made the poster. Chris Douglas Roberts with a sensational game. It was all Memphis down the stretch. A very impressive performance.
Memphis, a 78-63 winner. We are joined now by Tigers head coach John Calipari and his outstanding guard, Chris Douglas Roberts, who are headed to Monday night's national championship game. If this feels familiar, it's because we did this a week ago with you guys. You were very confident then. It shows that you guys were right. John, all the things that your guys did correctly tonight, what's the one thing that you're proudest of?
They competed on a team that wins with rebounding.
and we out-rebounded them. And that's a hard thing. I mean, they offensive rebound as well as any team in the country. That's how UCLA buries you. I also thought we did a good job defensively of playing the players that we knew were dangerous, Collison and Love. And we really did a good job of helping and doing some good things, but we really competed. I mean, we played unleashed. We had fun. I was happy for them.
Chris, talk to me about how you've elevated your play in the tournaments. You've had a terrific year all season long, but what's been the difference for you to take your game to another level here in the tournament?
Now it's win or go home. And my team depends on me, and they rely on me a lot to do so many things on the floor, and I really don't want to let them down. So me, it's not just me. The whole team, we've all elevated our game. We don't want to lose. It's really simple. We hate losing. The game, the one game we lost, we still feel bad about that one. So it's all about not our will to win.
Hey, John, this is the third straight game now where your size advantage on the perimeter was clearly demonstrative. And I'm just wondering how much you look to exploit that going into a game. For example, tonight it looked like whoever Darren Collison for UCLA was playing, he's only 6 feet tall, maybe 5'11", that whoever he was guarding was going to take him off the dribble. Is that the kind of matchup you're looking to exploit during a game?
Not only off the dribble, we were trying to post him up some. So whether it was Antonio or whether it was Chris or Derrick Rose, we are playing those mismatches, but it's only a part of our game. The driving and the spacing of the court and trying to get guys to that rim. The best thing we're doing right now is not settling for contested jump shots. If we have to, we'll run the clock down. But our execution right now has been very good. We're not turning it over that much, and we're a very unselfish basketball team.
Cal, congratulations. I'm happy for you, and congratulations, Chris Douglas-Roberts. I thought Chris Douglas-Roberts and Derrick Rose had a tremendous game, but Cal, there was a point in the game with about 13 minutes to go in the second half. There was a clip, I don't know if you can see it, where you really were going after Joey Dorsey, and I thought his whole disposition in the second half changed, and him grabbing 15 rebounds and not scoring a point, I thought was big for your team. I'd like to know, one, what you said to him, and two, how do you think he responded from that?
Well, the biggest thing is, it's like my daughter Erin says, when she watches him play, he's a beast. He's a beast. Well, he wasn't playing like a beast. He was accepting being blocked out. He was accepting being pushed. My thing is, he is a 15-point, 20-rebound, 4-5-block player. When I'm not seeing that, it makes me angry, because that's what I think he is. And our team even said to him in a huddle, guy, you're looking like you're sad. Smile. We're having a ball out here. Your body language makes it like you're being negative. He could be that dominating player. And he was at times. He was as big a part of us winning this game as anybody.
Coach and Chris, before we let you go, you guys are sitting there watching the first half of what's taking place in game two. I want to know if you guys are impressed by the Kansas Jayhawks as we are back here in the studio.
I'm very impressed, but I've been impressed with them the entire year. I mean, they run, they're athletic. You know, I know I can't say they're supposed to be up, but I don't feel this game is over at all, because North Carolina is a great team too. But the way they're playing, they should definitely be up right now.
Well, I'll tell you this. North Carolina will make two or three more runs. You know it, and I know it. And it's a great challenge for Kansas.
Coach John Calipari, Chris Douglas-Roberts, congratulations to you. We'll look for you again on Monday night. Thanks for your time.
Thanks, you guys.
You betcha. Our thanks also to Coach Billy Donovan for spending some time with us tonight. He's had all the free food he can possibly eat.
I can't eat anymore.
Great. Good to have you, Billy.
It was great being with you guys. I had a ball, and you guys are first class and pros.
Only this year, though. Next year, you're coaching.
That's right. All right.
1 year.
Thank you.
That's all for this edition of AT&T at the Half. The second half of Kansas and North Carolina comes your way right after this.
CBS Sports presents AT&T at the Half. Your world. Delivered.
Jim Nance with Billy Packer here in San Antonio. And Kansas had a lead as large as 28. Who will meet Memphis on Monday night? Will Kansas close this thing out, or will North Carolina pull off the biggest comeback ever at a Final Four? That Rock Chalk defense with 5 blocks and 7 steals. Some dominating play inside too, Billy.
Oh, it really has been, and I thought that the game plan that Bill Self had early is to force Tyler Hansbrough to guard somebody down in low. They went to their big guys inside, kept him occupied, and then the double teaming from the weak side was the great defensive play by Kansas. Here's Rushen. I think he exemplifies what Kansas has done in the first half. Jim, they shot 54%, 18 for 33 from the field. Terrific first half. But Jimmy, I'm going to warn that right now, if you're a Kansas team, you go in there at halftime, you know that Bill Self has to say, hey, probably the most important 3 minutes of the season is going to happen right now, because you have to show again that you can regain control of this ball game. They were really tired at the end of first half.
Oh, there you go. What a perfectly executed play. Backdoor, they go to Jones.
You want to go into the locker room and look on the blackboard? That was the play.
North Carolina had one big sizable comeback this year, 14 down at the half against Boston College. But this is Kansas. Now it's 19.
Boy, that was a great set play, wasn't it? There comes that weak side help again. Hands like for a have, walk.
Yeah, no
got
call.
Away with it. Yeah.
Definitely traveled.
Looked like the referees were looking for the upper body. Kansas let the game get away from them about the last 4 minutes of the first half, taking some bad shots. And
I think they ran out of gas, Billy. I think
you're right. I think they just wore down a little bit and made some mental misjudgments.
Arthur from the outside.
Nice soft shots been hitting in the first half, but that put him back about 2 or 3 feet further than he'd like to shoot that shot.
And North Carolina is going to turn it right over for the backcourt violation. Here's the in-game box score powered by CBS College Sports Network, the 24-hour college sports channel from CBS Sports. Hansbrough with 10 points, 5 rebounds, but it's Rush. They spread it around. Chalmers with 7.
Jim, you remember a game, I believe we did it together back in 95, and UCLA had Kansas down 41-22.
Yes, I do.
So that's
out
the biggest
Crawley Pavilion.
Yep,
biggest. Here's Ellington.
That was the biggest comeback ever for a Kansas team. They did it against the UCLA club. And then we had that Arizona comeback against Kansas.
Chalmers just handing it off to Jackson.
Much, much too easy.
How will North Carolina have any way of getting back into this game, Billy?
Well,
what
Jim,
will they have to do?
The way they got it back in the first half was pushing the ball up the floor. There, Hansbrough does a good job seeing the weak side help coming over and made it easy. This is the way North Carolina should have started the ball game.
Deion Thompson with that basket.
Ooh, dangerous.
That could
pass.
Have been stolen. Rush on the fly. What a night.
North Carolina's defense still doesn't have a lot of intensity. Kansas getting good looks.
Lawson drives it in and scores. Up and down the floor we go. Here's Chalmers squaring up for a three. Oh, Rush on the follow-up.
That was a perfect pass. Derek Wittenberg, Lorenzo Charles.
Yes.
Bad shot, perfect pass.
Lawson, no. Hansbrough. And one. Hansbrough got hit in the face.
And he lost his contact lens, but he keeps running. There you see Hansbrough. Look at him coming down that middle. Nobody blocking him out. He continually runs. He uses that great speed, straightaway speed that he has to get to the ball.
Sasha Kahn back out for Kansas. He played only 2 minutes in that first half as Aldrich saw 13 minutes of action and led them in rebounds with 6.
He played like an All-American in that first half. Jim, when you think about, we talked about the quick legs and we talked about the intensity. North Carolina in that first half only had 2 assists. They had 10 turnovers. Kansas had 5 blocks and 7 steals. You start talking about dominance.
That's versus no blocks and only 2 steals for the Heels. That just again supports the theory about every loose ball, the quick feet, the tip out to Jackson.
That was Kahn that got that one.
Rush is going to be against Carolina.
That was a good job by Rush. He was going to make himself have a shot. Ellington never got over in front of him.
For Ellington, that's his 2nd.
Rush thought he would go to the line, too, because he almost was able to make that referee call that in the act of shooting. And if you're North Carolina, you cannot get in a trading of basket game here. Oh, there's a quick cheap foul. Hansbrough trying to go out for a steal.
His 2nd. Billy, you said the first 3 minutes would be so crucial for Kansas, and basically they played Carolina to a standstill out of the locker room.
Give Bill Self a lot of credit setting up that initial possession. The nice backdoor cut, half-court move.
Robinson has to come back out.
North Carolina working much harder now defensively.
Chalmers, open alley.
Thompson just letting him have the shot. Hansborough open, Cons behind him. North Carolina didn't let him have the touch.
Thompson's blocked but fouled on Jackson. It'll be his third. Tuesday on CBS, your favorite stars reveal secret talents never seen before. Don't miss the premiere of Secret Talents of the Stars. It's Tuesday at 10, 9 Central on CBS.
You know, Jim, as Jackson made that foul, I started thinking, when are we going to see Aldridge? And out of the corner of my eye, I saw Bill Self turn, and here comes Aldridge.
Green coming back out for North Carolina, and the man they call Q, Quentin Thomas, Lawson and Ellington to the Carolina bench. Robinson's replaced, as is Jackson.
And if you're Thomas right now, what you've got to do is start distributing the basketball. Try to get everybody involved that's on the floor right now, particularly Hansborough. Green did his job coming off that bench, making some things happen in the first half.
He's the one that really gave him that 15-4 run to close out the half. Carolina now 9 out of 10 at the line.
North Carolina trying to trap half court, and it cost them.
Rush. Not this time on the open three.
The first time North Carolina tried to do that in this ball game, a half court trap. Gave Rush a wide open shot. Normally he'll bury that.
Green, he buries it.
As I said, he's the kind of guy come off the bench and be a star.
Chipping away, it's now 14. They've gotten halfway there. They were down 28 in the first. Conn on the inside, it's gonna go against Kansas, and Conn's collected his third.
Not the way Bill Self wanted those first 3 minutes to go.
Halftime lead was 17. It's now down to 14. We've had a 14-point swing over the last 9 minutes. Remember, this was 40-12 in Carolina now, a 28-14 run. And in the second half, Ellington driving in. Green has given them valuable minutes, as he has so often this season. He's got 11 on the night, Billy.
And Jim, what is really critical now for North Carolina, bringing it back this far down, is to get it to single digits and still play the way that they're playing right now. Is a much calmer game. This is the way we thought they'd play in the beginning of the ball game. I don't know, the team that showed up is one I've never seen play.
Green back of the rim, and it rattles out. Loose ball. And again, it's Kansas with Arthur.
And let's see if Kansas will go back and start feeding the ball down inside where they were so effective early in this ball game.
Hansborough, that time telegraphed.
Yeah, he jumped right in front. He has another steal. Hansborough came down the court, and that's delayed break. But a good job by Arthur picking him up.
Ginyard in traffic, blocked. Bring it back out. Shot clock's at 15. It's a 2-point shot by Green. He's got the hot hand for the heels.
As I said, Jim, he can be a star off the bench.
Timeout, Kansas.
Bill Self upset with his ball club. It is getting closer.
Jim, what do you see here?
Yeah, the big key there is North Carolina shooting 60% in this second half. Kansas nowhere near the defensive intensity we saw early on when they exploded to that big lead.
Thomas right in the face of Collins. Green comes over to double team. They've got him pinned and a tie up, and the arrow's going with Carolina.
Jim, again, North Carolina jumping to their half court trap. Second time it's been used effectively here in the second half. And the key at the 14 mark, you want to get this thing down below double digits before the 10-minute mark without pushing.
A
Robinson, a good defender, but Green's pretty strong.
Hansbrough thought about launching it. That's Ellington. Two-point shot, and it's down to 10.
Well, I said before the 10-minute mark, it looks like they're going to get there even before that. And you can see that this Kansas team right now is starting to worry. North Carolina dropping back.
Rush way short, but it comes back to him. Gets it out on the floor, Carolina.
Now North Carolina's getting the loose balls, unlike the first half.
Ball with this be big. Ellington.
Pretty good block out that time. Stevenson not able to get to the ball.
Had a chance to trim it to 7. Robinson kicks it back over Rush. Short with his last two.
And again, North Carolina getting the loose balls. No place for Thomas to go.
But Collins spins away after making the steal. Driving in. Rejected by Green. And a charge call on Kansas and Collins.
Jim, have you ever seen a team that played so well, making so many mental mistakes as Kansas is right now? That is a 1-against-4 by Collins. No place to go. Bill Self talking to him right now on the other side. They are not giving any credence whatsoever of how important possession of the ball is.
He said Carolina must get it into single digits. Here's their chance. We still have 13 minutes to go in the game.
And Lawson back in the game fresh now. Robinson Green, this is a nice matchup here.
Green snaps it over Thompson. Quick hands, almost a theft by Robinson. Green,
blocked.
Ellington, no, it's Arthur who gets it over to Rush. Robinson from the wing. Green taps it out. They got a 3-on-2. He's going to challenge Arthur, and it's a charge. Charge call against Danny Green.
Both teams not making good judgments when they've got an advantage on the break.
Second foul on Green. They've had a couple of chances down the floor.
Absolutely. There's no place to go right there if you're Danny Green. It was the same as Collins on the other end of the floor. Mental mistakes.
Green out. Dinyard in.
You see Rush down in the corner practicing his jump shot, Jim, without a ball in his hand, knowing that he wasn't shooting with a nice aggressive stroke the last two jumpers.
Kansas has missed its last 7 attempts from 3. It's starting to look very tight. Stolen. Ellington spinning away. Ellington fade away under 10.
Good pull up. Bill Self is going to ask for a timeout. His team now is as out of sync as North Carolina was in the first half.
Looks like panic is setting in. Carolina's right back in it, down 8. Carolina storming back here in the second half. They actually began to chip away late in the first. Danny Green giving them a big boost. He's the one who really kind of fueled this comeback when they were down 28.
He did, Jimmy. He was putting up shots that looked good and solid. He's not sitting on the bench right now, but you know he's going to get back in there soon. The original starting lineup on the floor now for North Carolina. And Kansas, when's the last time we saw them go high-low and get the ball down in the low post as they started the game so effectively? Everything has been ball on the floor, jump shots.
No basket made in 4.5 minutes. Ellington on the chase. He has the steal. He has Lawson. Blocked by Rush. Hansbrough up and in and one.
Well, we've seen some comebacks, Jim, but I'll have
this
to be honest.
Be.
I have never seen anything like this.
There's his father. This would be the mother of all comebacks.
Well, and the reason is because of the way the teams dominated in the first half like Kansas. North Carolina had no legs. They got to no loose balls. And now it's just the opposite here in the second half.
Hansbrough can bring it to 5. Oh, and a rare miss.
Again, if you're Kansas, I think you got to go to the high-low game again and get your big guys involved in the offense.
A 12-0 run by the Tar Heels. That's going against Lawson. His first. We're going to have a break. The under 12 break from 28-6. The fortunes of Kansas have flipped over these last 13 minutes. Kansas inbounding with 11:39 remaining.
And Jim, they've gotten completely away from doing anything with their big men offensively. Everything's been a high screen and roll.
Blank for over 5 minutes. Over the top, here's the play you were calling for, and a travel against Arthur.
That's a good idea, but not well executed. The Kansas players are starting to look like they're really concerned. There's not that smile on the face. There's not that look of determination.
Tight.
Yep.
Is the word. 8 turnovers in this half alone for Kansas in 8.5 minutes.
Look at the set now that North Carolina is being able to operate just the way they want to.
Backdoor, Chalmers slipped, and Ellington took advantage.
This is North Carolina basketball we're seeing now, not the team we saw at the beginning.
Ellington, if he didn't block it so forcefully, he could have tapped it over to Lawson. It'll be Kansas ball.
And what we see similar to what happened in the first game tonight, like UCLA trying to go 1-1 with every play. North Carolina, on the other hand, gotten back to their half-court offense.
And North Carolina scored the last 14 in this game.
That could be picked off. Roy Williams doing a nice job going from his man-to-man to those half-court traps.
Will step up for Kansas and get him out of this. Will it be Jackson? Jumper, no. Tipped up, Rush. Squeezes it in.
He hadn't been able to make the jump shot, so does a good job rebounding. As a freshman, first freshman ever in Kansas history to lead him in scoring and rebounding. Showed you his rebounding potential right there.
Breaks a 6-minute drought. Lawson wildly lost control of it going up, and it's Rush again.
Probably should have picked up and taken the little jump shot inside.
Kansas trying to regain his composure.
But they are looking inside more now, Jim.
Over the top, Jackson's right there.
There it is.
From 4 to 8. Ellington guns it. Chases it down. Great hustle to save it for Carolina. Under 10 minutes to play. Lawson lobs it up. No. Hansbrough tip. Arthur clear. Kansas now with a little flurry.
They didn't have numbers and wisely pull it back out. Let's see if they go back into the inside again. Khan going to come in, who hasn't been effective here in this ball game.
Taken out early with a couple of fouls. Chalmers, he wants it, fires it. No.
Ooh, that was some rebound.
Boy, he took out Jackson. Ellington on the wing. This is his shot. He hits it.
Terrific pull up by Ellington. Isn't it amazing how much more positive the North Carolina players look right now than the Kansas players? I've never been involved with a game that turned this rapidly and the emotionally looking at the faces of the players. Kansas smiling in that first half, confident, quick. Just the opposite in the second.
Yeah, concern written all over them now. Collins with 4 on the shot clock. Arthur with 1 on the shot clock. Not going to get it away. You can watch exclusive video of Amen Corner Live, plus all the action at the 15th and 16th holes live. It's all coming up next week. Bonus coverage of the entire field with Masters Extra. CBSSports.com/MastersLive and Masters.org.
Jim, in that first half, you had North Carolina with 2 assists and 10 turnovers. The second half, you have Kansas with 9 turnovers.
Rush and Hansbrough are sitting down as we approach that under 8-minute timeout.
Danny Green's back in, so he's a key. Robinson guarding him, and there's a reach.
Chalmers, as Graves has come in here for North Carolina. Chalmers, that's number 3.
You have to like the situation. Chalmers on Graves, he's much quicker.
The cans of Robinson trying to stir something up. Almost does.
Stevenson is shaky ball handler.
This is a tougher lineup to find points for North Carolina.
Yes, it is. Danny Green's got to be the answer. Here he is.
This could get it to 2, and it rattles out.
There was a case, if Graves leaves it alone, Stevenson has a layup.
No, with no challenge at all. Well, that one circled the rim, though, didn't it? The green three.
It sure did. But right now, North Carolina has a funny lineup on the floor offensively. They've only got one score.
Graves quickly on the spot defensively. Now Kahn. Blocked. Follow up. No, but a foul. Aldridge will be shooting two out of the timeout. Ellington with 11 in the second half. North Carolina trying to make history, trying to pull up the biggest comeback in Final Four history. The National Player of the Year, Tyler Hansbrough, trying to lead North Carolina all the way back. Have they expended too much energy to get back into this thing? Will they have anything left at the end?
Jim, you know, I don't think they have expended too much energy. I think that they have just played solid defense and they've moved the ball better offensively. It's been Kansas mentally not looking to put up the shots they did in the first half. And what really cost them is when they had the working margin the end of the first half and took some bad shots. So they actually played into North Carolina's hands.
Cole Aldridge hit two free throws in the first half. Actually was given a mulligan after someone. Carolina and a lane violation. Now 3 for 3. The freshman stepping up so big here tonight.
Well, in the first half, 6.6 rebounds, 2 assists, 3 blocks, and
got
a steal.
4 blocks now.
Yep. Funny looking free throw, but he hits both of them.
And Arthur's going to replace him.
Now with Ellington in the game, Green in the game, Hansbrough, North Carolina's got 3 ways to attack offensively. One of those three should take this next shot.
Here it is to Hansbrough.
Double team, though.
Tough shot.
Yeah, too tough a shot. He pushed off, too.
It's going to be his third.
He was too anxious to take that one. Good defense that time to double down. Sasha Kahn and Arthur did a real good job.
That little Hansbrough flick of a shot that you so often talk about. It has been really challenged today, as much as we've seen Kansas staying right with him.
Well, he does a lot of good things, but that was not a good shot he took there.
On the shot clock. Kansas looking for a little comfort. Lob it. Kahn delivers. Oh, what a Kansas moment.
Boy, they read that beautifully. Kahn set the screen. Collins knew he was going to roll to the basket.
Back up to 9. Ellington fades away.
He loves that stuff.
Follow up. Green hits the floor. No call, but gets the basket.
The star off the bench is Danny Green.
Got free, and Green slaps it out of bounds. Sasha Kahn from Tomsk, Russia. Didn't play basketball until the 10th grade. He came over to the States just to get an education.
Hey, Jim, Green has blocked 36 shots on the year, and Hansbrough has blocked 13. So you wonder which guy got a piece of that ball?
It was Green. Now Kansas again. Fighting a shot clock, 6:20 to go in the game. Dish, Kahn, he delivers twice now, once on a dunk, once on a little flip bank shot as the shot clock was running down.
And he was 6 for 6, 13 and 6 in that big game and win over Davidson, so he's picking up right where he left off.
Whistle on Arthur this week on The Late Show. Dave's got Jim Carrey, Will Ferrell, and Steve Martin, and on Monday, catch Bruce Willis and Sylvester Stallone only on CBS. That was actually on Collins, and that was his third foul. Thompson with one more coming.
Well, North Carolina shoots 75% as a team, but right here on the line, Deion Thompson's only a 58% free throw shooter. Looked pretty good on that last one.
Yes, he did. Perfect form and all net. Again, delivers.
See if North Carolina tries to go to their half-court trap here. It was effective for them as a little change of pace.
Here it comes. Rush on the wing, three long. Lawson.
And Rush still trying to find his jump shot. He had it in the first half and has lost it now.
It's disappeared. Angelo passes up the open baseline. Oh, what a tough shot. Back down to five.
Threw that from behind his head.
It did.
Collins thinking about that lob again, maybe?
Three-pointer instead. Sherron Collins hit the shot before the end of the first half. It's a big three on that one.
But both of these teams have a guy coming off the bench who could star. Sherron Collins and Danny Green.
Ellington, another wild shot. He threw that one up from his hip.
Well, give North Carolina a lot of credit in this particular case. They did not throw in the towel. I thought this game was over long ago in the first half.
Rush. Beautiful move.
Thompson not helping out defensively. Ellington will take that jumper.
Going back to Kansas. A quick trip for Carolina that time.
Too easy getting that ball inside. No weak side defensive help by North Carolina inside. You see who stays on the floor. Collins stays out there, Jim. It's a tough matchup.
Got a timeout called by North Carolina. Tomorrow on CBS, the drama continues on an all-new episode of Cold Case. Cold Case tomorrow at 9, 8 Central on CBS. Kansas leads it by 8, Billy. 4:47 to play.
Right here in 1998, the same place. Utah beat that North Carolina club in the semifinal round. Went on then and were beaten by Tubby Smith's outstanding Kentucky team. It had that incredible comeback of, remember, 18 points against Duke.
In the St. Petersburg regional final, yeah. They were the comeback cats, and they were down 10 at halftime. And that was the biggest championship game comeback in history, right here at the Alamo Dome.
What was Duke, something like 18 points in 8 minutes and some seconds.
Carolina going to pick up full court.
Not a bad idea. Now, if they're going to do that half court trap, you look on the floor, Rush is the guy that's probably going to have the open jumper down in the corner. He's got to be ready to take it. Here's Ginyard looking around, but he's not going to trap because Rush took him down on the baseline. Here comes the trap. There's the jump shot.
Rush lobs it instead to Jackson. Lob City for Kansas.
You knew the trap was coming. Rush did the right thing.
Ginyard with a three.
Not a good three-point shooter.
Collins outmuscles everyone for that one. Jayhawks back up to 10.
Now in a position to use some clock.
Pickett corner. Rush rattles out. Tipped out Kansas.
Is Collins getting every loose ball now?
For the last minute he has. Jackson.
Roy Williams needs a timeout here. His team's letting it get away from him. He's still got time, but he can't let this game keep rolling on.
Jackson with 10, 8 in this half. They call on Danny Green and Thomas to come on the next whistle. Hansbrough shot, tough one. Well defended. Back to Hansbrough. Travel. Back to Kansas.
Great help from all players there on Hansbrough.
Kansas has opened it back up on a 6-0 run. Back up 12. North Carolina have whittled it down to 4 after being 28 down in the first half. Kansas responding. They're on a 19-11 stretch, including the last 6.
And Jim, what brought them back is going inside again and getting away from that strictly perimeter game.
Got a 3-on-2. Collins pull-up jumper. Tipped around into the hands of Thompson.
Ellington down on the side. Rush sees him over there. Ellington Hansbrough got to take the shots the rest of the way.
Here's Ellington. Three is off the mark. Carolina's gone cold.
Nice pull up by Chalmers here. Going to force North Carolina to play some half court defense.
North Carolina only 4 out of 19 from behind the line. Rush.
Could be a big call here, but I think it's going to be a block on the inside by Thompson.
Two shots coming.
Jim, you talk about this Kansas club and the balance that they have. Tonight's a good example of it. 8 players have scored there. On the year, this team has had 7 different guys have been leading scorers, 7 different guys have been the leading rebounders, 5 different guys have been the leading assist man in the game, and 6 have scored 20 points or more in a game. That is terrific balance and hard to defend.
They probably would have had a 9th scorer in the act if Roderick Stewart hadn't fractured his knee. There he is. What a sad story that was for that young man, a senior, just out here in the shoot-around yesterday before a large throng in the stands, the open practice. He's going to have surgery when they get back to Lawrence. Didn't want to have it here. That's a Carolina turnover. He wanted to stay here and cheer on his teammates.
What I'm wondering is, why is Lawson not in the ball game now to penetrate and do some kicking out?
Fractured a knee just going up for a dunk at the end of the shoot-around. It was an agony out here on the floor. Just last week, Rick Barnes was telling us in Houston he won't let his team do that in these shoot-arounds because so many balls are rolling around on the floor, so many distractions, could be an injury, and that's what happened. Rush! Oh, yes, on the other side. Now Rush having a big night.
Now that North Carolina's taking the chances defensively, Kansas doing a great job recognizing what's going on.
Kansas starting to pull away. 9-0 run.
Collins so strong, and when he dribbles low to the ground like that, very difficult to get to him. Here is Lawson, going to be coming back in a ball game with Ginyard. Kind of an interesting 3 different games we had here.
Absolutely. This is game 3. This is act 3 right here.
This game 3, all Kansas. Just when North Carolina looked like they could pull off one of the most miraculous comebacks we've ever seen.
You never had a doubt Kansas was going to win this game, did you?
You know, I didn't. And you know, when the game started, and you know, I said this game was over early because you never saw any indication North Carolina was going to get their act together, and they really didn't. As much as Kansas got sloppy there at about the 6-minute mark in that first half, got a little overconfident.
You declared it at 7:32 to go first half.
Is that what
it
said?
It shocked me.
Well, you know, you say what you see.
No,
you know?
That's why I love you. Now one more for Collins. Got them both. Larry Brown, what ties he has to these two programs, and he's encouraging North Carolina.
Yes, he's encouraging North Carolina to move forward. I think what he probably wanted to see was a good game by either team.
No for Hansbrough. Into the arms of Collins.
Collins has gotten so many loose balls, key rebounds in traffic. And now with the ball in his hands, he's tough to stop.
That was a fascinating cutaway, wasn't it? The man who won a championship for Kansas back in 88. And his Rush has 2 more.
Well, where did he go to college though?
I know his roots and his bloodlines with North Carolina run so deep. Roy Williams, who took over just a few months after that championship.
And you know what's really, really interesting, talking about Larry Brown. He's one of 3 guys to take 2 different teams to the championship game. Larry Brown did it with UCLA and Kansas. Roy Williams did it with Kansas and UNC. And then Frank McGuire did it with St. John's in North Carolina. McGuire winning a championship in 57, Brown winning his championship at Kansas, and Roy Williams winning a championship at North Carolina. Kind of interesting. 3 guys, all with ties to Chapel Hill.
Arnell Jackson coming back in. Again, Carolina somehow was able to bring it from 28 to 4. That free throw by Lawson just ended a 13-0 Kansas spree. Did they just run out of gas here after the big comeback, or what?
Well, in our third,
what it looked like
in our third period, Kansas wins.
Be interesting to see with Memphis and the way they have dominated the star guards of the opponent here in the tournament, whether it was Neitzel or Augustine, or in this case tonight, Collison, how the Chalmers, Collins, Robinson trio and Brandon Rush, how they can do against Memphis on Monday night.
Well, probably a little better matchup size-wise than what they faced both in the UCLA situation and in the Texas situation and in the Michigan State situation.
Plus, you got the matchup of Dorsey and Dozier against the likes of Arthur and Jackson and Sasha Khan.
And Aldridge.
Should be a terrific matchup.
It should be. You've got the four big men that rotate. You've got the rotation of with Tiger coming into the ball game for Memphis as well. Should be quite a matchup. And I got to give Bill Self a lot of credit too for pulling his team back when things were getting away from him and going back to getting the ball inside, utilizing his big men on lobs and hitting down inside to make North Carolina play honestly. Five times to a regional final, never to a Final Four. Now he finds himself in the championship game.
Collins is the one with the ball in his hand. So many times that's been the case tonight.
Absolutely, particularly in this third period, as we're calling it. They will have to give that ball up.
Able to answer the huge challenge after they'd seen almost all of it given up, that big lead. Robinson on the inside.
Boy, any gamble whatsoever by North Carolina goes right to a layup for Kansas.
Danny Green, Ellington, back out Lawson. Final 20 seconds. He's got a three.
That's about the first jump shot I remember him taking all night.
Timeout called by North Carolina. To think Bill Self had won one game in this building before, Billy. He had won here at the Alamo Dome. He beat Kansas, of yeah. all teams, when he was the coach at Illinois in a Sweet 16 game. And now he's going to take Kansas in this building to the championship game on Monday night.
Of course, we remember Kansas getting to a national championship final with Syracuse not too long ago.
You know, we're going to have two coaches on Monday night who really got their break in coaching as just really being like a gopher assistant coach, a volunteer assistant in Lawrence, Kansas.
With Larry Brown?
With Larry Brown.
How about that? And still are close with him to this day.
In Perry's case, he really started with Owens at first, but ended up there with Larry Brown.
Bill Self said he just showed up for work. Said, you promised to hire me. I haven't heard from you since, so I'm here to work. Had a pretty fair career, Eddie.
I'm telling you, and it can get even better. Monday night, Kansas and Memphis will duel for the title. The Jayhawks withstand the storm and take it to the Tar Heels, 84-66. They had an 18-0 run in the first half, a 13-0 run in the second, in the late going. Memphis wins by 15. Kansas by 18, and those two will tangle here in Texas for the national championship on Monday night. Roy Williams, who just this past fall went into the Hall of Fame. Spectacular season, but it ends tonight in San Antonio. Greg Gumbel and the team back in New York will send it to them after a break, and we'll hear from Kansas shortly.
Coming up next, here on CBS, for many of you, your late local news. The score from tonight's second national semifinal. Kansas wins over North Carolina, 84-66 is the final score. Our Chevy most valuable players of this game, Brandon Rush, 25.7 rebounds for the Kansas Jayhawks. For North Carolina, Wayne Ellington, who had 18 points and 6 rebounds. March Madness 2008 culminates Monday night. CBS Sports coverage begins at 9 Eastern with Prelude to a Championship, followed by the NCAA Championship game between Kansas and Memphis. Right now, Jim Nance and Billy Peck are standing by on court with the victorious Jayhawks back to San Antonio. Jim?
Coach Bill Self in Kansas, congratulations. I said, how was it waiting around all day to play in the second game? And, well, how did you spend your afternoon? They won't believe this.
I slept.
You slept off?
I haven't slept in a week, so it's a good time to get caught up today.
You know, Billy and I were saying this was like three different games. Just remarkable start by your team. Carolina's great comeback, and then you guys with another big burst at the end.
Well, we played great early. I mean, it was as good as we can play, and we were fortunate. They missed some shots, but we really guarded them. And then we went brain dead from about the 3-minute mark of the first half to about the 10-minute mark of the second half, and then we finished so strong late.
You're playing for the national championship on Monday night. What does that sound like?
Sounds pretty good. Sounds real good.
Come on in here.
Brandon Rush.
Brandon, a terrific ball game. I saw you during a period of time down in the deep corner shooting the ball like an imaginary jump shot. Did all of a sudden that shot get away from you?
It did tonight. It came up a little short, but I still managed to get to the hole and get some easy baskets.
How about those lobs that you guys started to go back inside with, Bill? Is that something you designed, or you realize you got away from the inside game?
Well, we did. We made shots early, and so when we started missing shots, guys kept shooting them, though. So we had to get the ball back in tight, and we did. We had some great finishes around the rim.
If I go to the locker room, will I find that play you designed in the start of the second half still on the board?
Maybe. I don't know. Maybe.
Hey, Billy, I got Sherron Collins over here. Hit a big shot right before halftime and was all over the floor tonight. How does this feel for you and your teammates?
I feel good. You know, we got another step to take on Monday night. You know, we're going to play against a good Memphis team. But tonight, we just came out and tried to play hard. And I think we did that.
And these guards from Memphis have had a spectacular tournament, too. What about that matchup?
It's going to be a great matchup. You know, they play fast. We play fast. We play aggressive. It's going to be a good game.
Congratulations, guys. Kansas, Monday night for the national championship. We're going to send it back to New York. Back to you, Greg. We'll see everybody back here in San Antonio on Monday for Memphis and Kansas on CBS.
Hey, remember, your late local news is coming up next for many of you. Once again, our final score, Game 2, North Carolina, falling to Kansas by a score of 84-66. Greg Gumbel back in the studio, along with Clark Kellogg and Seth Davis. Have we figured out just what happened in this game?
Well, I tell you what, I thought Kansas was really terrific. They did a nice job defensively, and they really bottled up Tyler Hansbrough inside. But I thought it was the speed and tenacity on the perimeter that got them off to such a great start. Then they finished strong to pull away from Carolina after North Carolina had made a tremendous run to get back in it.
And I think Bill Self made a great adjustment in going back into the paint, as Billy Packer kept emphasizing throughout the game. And even though Brandon Rush was a player of the game, I think the most valuable player for Kansas was Sherron Collins, who brought them Chicago toughness in the second half. And I can't wait on Monday night for him to go head-to-head with another great Chicago point guard in Derrick Rose. Collins gives them the mental toughness they needed to pull it out.
Didn't you love the way Bill Self described it? We went brain dead at the end of the first half and for the first 10 minutes of the second half.
They did. They forgot about going inside. They took quick shots, and as a result, North Carolina was able to get back into the ball game. And to their credit, North Carolina trapped, became more aggressive defensively. But in the end, in the last 6 or 7 minutes, North Carolina had no answer in the paint area, and Kansas was able to get high-quality shots pretty much all game long.
84-66 Jayhawks, the final score. One final timeout, and we'll be back with more right after this. Don't go away. Once again, we remind you, coming up next for many of you, your late local news as you take a look at Tyler Hansbrough's dad, Gene, still suffering the effects as Carolina comes out on the short end of an 84-66 score at the hands of Kansas. Monday night, our exclusive live primetime coverage of the 2008 NCAA Men's Basketball Championship game tips off at 9 Eastern with Prelude to a Championship, followed by the NCAA title game, Kansas against Memphis. I don't know about you, but if Kansas and Memphis come out on Monday night and play the way they played tonight, we could all be out of breath.
Yeah, we really will be, because both of those teams played extremely well today at both ends of the floor. You think about the matchup on Monday night. Derrick Rose and Chris Douglas Roberts have carried the offensive load for Memphis all season. That will be something to keep an eye on. But the front line of Kansas, the Jayhawks, have a number of active, athletic, big bodies that could be a problem for Memphis inside.
I think Memphis should probably be considered the favorite, but I will say this. I think it's a comfortable matchup for Kansas to play that up and down style. One thing you saw what they were able to do tonight was play great transition defense. North Carolina was not able to get out on that fast break, and obviously Memphis really thrives on that. If Kansas can keep those 3 or 4 jerseys ahead of the ball on Monday night, I think that might give them an advantage, because now Memphis has to play against a team where their transition defense is going to be critical, and they haven't really played any teams that are quite as fast as they are.
Clark, can I remind you that Seth picked Kansas in
you
the
certainly
second game?
Can. I'm happy for it. Well done. Well done, Seth.
who for are four number one seeds
of
right
all
here.
All of tonight's action. Check out NCAA March Madness highlights, powered by the first ever Pontiac G8, coming up next on the CBS College Sports Network, the new pulse of college sports. Tomorrow, start your sports viewing day here on CBS at noon Eastern with the CBS Sports Spectacular. Geico presents college basketball's 10 greatest dunkers. Then at 1 Eastern, out to Miami for live coverage of the Sony Ericsson Open men's final between Rafael Nadal and Nikolai Davidenko. At 3 Eastern, it's live final round coverage of the LPGA Craft Nabisco Championship. For Clark Kellogg, for Seth Davis, for all of us here at CBS Sports, I'm Greg Gumbel. Thanks for joining us. Good night from New York. We'll see you Monday.